Winchester has always been an innovator. They've produced dozens of shotguns, rifles, and cartridges. And one of the big ones in 1873 was the 4440 Winchester, or the 44 Winchester centerfire. And that was a big change. It was a centerfire. Prior to that, the 44 Henry Flat was a weak rimfire cartridge. Well, they built a beefier rifle to handle it, the famous 1873. And that went on to be kind of a specialty rifle because of some certain accuracy parameters. What were those?
Yeah, well, this isn't just any ordinary 1873. This is one of the coveted one of 1,000s. And so when Winchester would take a one out of 1,000s, they would send it out with the target that it produced, a specifically accurate grouping. It's very, very accurate. And so because it was so accurate, they would outfit it with upgraded sights, checkered stocks, extra finish, make it a really deluxe firearm. And there were only 136 of these made, and they would actually make one of 100s as well, and only 8 of those would be made.
Whoa. Mm-hmm. How did they test it for knowing that it was most accurate? I suspect they just had to shoot it, right?
Yep, in the test firing process, the ones that would produce, they would do a standard test firing process, mm-hmm. and the ones that would produce exceptionally accurate and tight groupings would be the ones that would distinguish the merit to be one in 1,000. Exceptionally accurate rifles.
Yeah, and this is one of them.
This is one of them. And they would not just stop doing the one of 1,000s and one of 100s in the 1873s, but they would continue that in the even larger caliber, larger frame 1876s. And we're actually standing with one of those right here as well. This
That's
is one
right
of the
there?
Model 1876 one of 1,000s.
Oh, yeah.
In 4560.
So the real only difference between the 73 model and the 76 is just a larger size of the whole frame, so you could shoot larger, stronger cartridges,
Absolutely.
Right?
Even though the 1873 had the famous marketing slogan, the gun that won the West, mm-hmm. it was really a call by big game hunters who wanted a larger, heavier caliber in the legendary repeating rifles from Winchester.
Certainly.
And so that's why the model 1876s had such a large frame and a large caliber for big game hunters.
Yeah. So the 4440 was sort of a working man's gun. Cowboys loved it because they'd carry it on their horse pretty easily in the on saddle, mm-hmm. Scabbard probably, or have a saddle ring on it. But they could also carry a six-shooter that was chambered for the same cartridge.
Absolutely.
Well, you can't chamber a six-shooter for a 45-70 or some other large. So if you were a serious big game hunter, that's when you wanted the 76, right?
Yep, and in the 1876s, there will only be 54 of the 1876 one of 1,000s produced, and only 7 of the 1 in 100 1876.
Wow, so they never made it to 1,000.
No.
It was one of a four, lot fewer. That would be a special rifle to own. You probably can't own it because it's out here in the museum in Cody. So if you want to see it, and hundreds of other wonderful Winchesters, stop on out. Cody, Wyoming, the Cody Firearms Museum. It's a great place to learn your history and see some firearms that are magnificent.
Absolutely.
Now listen, it's the 150th anniversary of Winchester. That's how long they've been making guns and ammo. So if you like to find out about your history and get a feel for how these rifles were designed and developed, in addition to coming out here, you can stay home, get online, go to winchester.com and check out your history there. It's a great place to get started. We're what you